Star Wars 7x7 episode number 1850 today, a sort of interview with Charlie Hall from Polygon about Doc Ondar's Den of Antiquities.
Oh, we're on. Okay.
Hey, Rebel Rouser. I'm Alan Voivod, and this is Star Wars 7x7. Thank you so much for joining us for this episode, because with me is...
me.
Scorekeeper Declan is making a triumphant return to the show.
Yes, that is me.
So here is the deal. Charlie Hall from Polygon wrote up an incredible piece on the Den of Antiquities, Doc Ondar's Den of Antiquities at Galaxy's Edge. I reached out to him to see if he would do an interview. Unfortunately, he was prepping for Gen Con, and so he was not able to do a real-time interview. However, he graciously answered questions that I sent to him via email. And so, for your benefit, we are going to reenact the interview here with Scorekeeper Declan playing the part of me, and me playing the part of Charlie Hall.
Hello, my name is Alan Voivod.
All right, so five questions for Charlie Hall. What? That wasn't fake.
It sounded fake.
No. Oh, I'm so sorry you thought it was, sweetheart.
Okay.
Oh, kids these days. Anyway, so, you ready for the interview?
Sure.
Okay. Just remember, this is audio too, so not everybody's going to see you shrugging as well, so you're going to have to be vocal with your stuff.
Got it!
Okay, great! Alright, let's get to the interview!
Did you enter the den with the intention of putting together this guide, or was the experience of the den so compelling that you decided to do it then and there?
And here's what Charlie Hall had to say. Our team absolutely went to Galaxy's Edge with the intention of putting together this and other stories from Disney's largest theme park land. We've been planning for months. Our full package includes dozens of articles from our trip, and there's a link that he shared that I will post in the show notes for today's episode. Next question.
The byline notes that photos and design were by James Barham?
That's good enough for me.
Can you tell me a bit of how the two of you collaborated on the guide?
James is a tremendous resource, and Charlie also shared a link to James's profile online, which I'll post in the show notes too. As a seasoned professional photographer and designer, I couldn't have done it without him. I basically did bad MS Paint drawings on the photos, and then he dressed them up in Polygon livery.
Before we do any more questions, I'm just saying we did not, like, rehearse this.
No, we did not.
So if I mess up, you're just gonna have to deal with it, I guess.
Yep, and same here. Same for me, too.
Okay. But you didn't?
No, I didn't rehearse this.
Diehard Star Wars fan.
I'm just doing it with you, man.
Yeah, okay. How long, ultimately, did it take you to prepare the guide for publication, research, and write-up time? That's in parentheses.
Yes. Just to give, like, Charlie an idea.
The parentheses start at research.
Got it. That's right.
And then ended time.
Excellent. Just to clarify the question for Charlie. And he said, I spent basically a full week on this, which is an extravagance that I don't often get anymore in my work.
Okay. What was the most difficult item to identify? And which one was your favorite? Starting parentheses. And why? End parentheses. Then question mark.
So he did not answer the favorite one, actually, but he did say the hardest one was the mace on the back wall, along with all the guns right behind Doc. I still don't know where that comes from, but it's right on the tip of my tongue. If anyone else recognizes that from somewhere in the lore, let me know. And if you're catching the audio version of this show, I will post a photo of that particular one for you to check out. So that way, if you have the answer, then you can share it.
Okay. Last question?
Yep.
No parentheses in this one. do you have the sense?
That was meant to be, do you have the sense, actually.
Do have the sense?
Yeah, typo when I sent the questions. It's true.
Do you have the sense or know from asking that the collection will change from time to time, and how often? Question mark.
Charlie says, no clue, but I do anticipate items being added after the most recent movie, that being The Rise of Skywalker. Of course, remember, this is Doc's shop on a specific day in Star Wars canon. That day would have to change, theoretically, for Doc's collection to be altered. It's clear that Disney has planned ahead to make that big change at some point in the future. Millennium Falcon Smuggler's Run could easily be renamed Millennium Falcon Title X and still retain the ride's original branding, but that would be a heavy land-wide change that would not be made lightly. And there is one other question that we asked, but I will share the details about that after the break. Stay tuned. This episode is brought to you by Constant Contact, the premier email marketing solution for small businesses and organizations. I've used their service since 2003, and over the past decade and a half, I've watched them evolve, make the product simpler, more powerful, easy to use, and do everything that they can to help train people to use the product more effectively and for it to work with other forms of marketing like social media, for example. So check out sw7x7.com/email to learn more about Constant Contact and start a free trial. Once again, that is sw7x7.com/email for a free trial.
What's up?
And welcome back. So there is one other question I asked Charlie Hall, and that question is, what's the question, Declan?
Your entries for a few of the items mentioned conversations with cast members. How well prepared did they seem to be or detailed questions about the artifacts in the den?
And I will be sharing the answer to that question on the patron exclusive feed for folks who have signed up for that level of patronage at patreon.com/sw7x7. So if you are a patron of the show, then please do check that out. And if you're not yet, then I hope you'll go over to patreon.com/sw7x7 and see about supporting the show and supporting this guy showing up more often on the show.
Well, he said.
Yeah, so for now, though, that's going to do it for this episode of the show. Thank you so much for joining me and the triumphant return of Scorekeeper Declan.
Yeah.
And may the Force be with you wherever in the world you may be.
Yep.
This podcast is not endorsed or sponsored yet by Lucasfilm Limited, Disney, or 20th Century Fox. It is intended for entertainment and information purposes only. Star Wars, the Star Wars logo, all names and pictures of Star Wars characters, vehicles, and any other related Star Wars items are registered trademarks and or copyrights of Lucasfilm Limited or their respective trademark and copyright holders. May the Force be with them. All original content is copyright 2019 by Star Wars 7x7. We hope you love it.